Hello, my name is Michael Yuan, and I'm an open source developer. I'm also the founder of a venture-backed software company called Second State. As software developers, we have all used cloud services. The typical process to use cloud services is first to create a virtual machine or containers that we would use, and then pay for and then allocate resources to those virtual machine or containers like bandwidth or disk space and things like that, and then pay for those resources even if they are idle. And then we can start considering deploying our software to them and then make them available to the world through the cloud. As you can see, this is a rather cumbersome process, and it has spun off a new software development field called DevOps. Those steps and constraints are necessary because cloud providers typically need to run arbitrary software written by unknown developers and then collect money for any resources that have been consumed by those software. This need to safely manage software from unknown sources is driving the complexity that I just have described. But what happened to the original vision of cloud computing? What happened to the idea of computing power can just be turned on like water from a faucet? Well, as a software developer, I want to simply write my software in any programming language or library and framework that I choose, upload and deploy it without thinking about the underlying resources such as CPU, GPU, storage, network, or even the operating system. And then only pay for those resources when I actually use them. This is what people call cloud-native computing. At Second State, we believe that bytecode virtual machines, you know, the high-level virtual machines that actually execute bytecode, not the operating system-level virtualization software like AWS Elastic Compute or Docker, are the best choices to hide infrastructure details from developers. Now, the software industry has a long history utilizing bytecode virtual machines. In the past, the Java virtual machine and JavaScript execution engines has been very successful in providing both secure and convenient containers on the server side. They both started as secure execution engines inside web browsers, but eventually find success on the server side. But in the world of new programming languages, think, say, Python, Go, Rust, TypeScript, etc. And in the world of new hardware, think new GPUs, AI inference chips, FGPAs, FPGAs, and things like that. We need new bytecode virtual machines beyond what Java and JavaScript can offer. We believe the answer is the new generation of new bytecode virtual machines called WebAssembly. WebAssembly was originally created by Mozilla, Google, Microsoft, and Apple to be a secure code execution environment inside web browsers. In other words, it aims to replace the old Java applet or JavaScript inside browser-based applications. In that regard, it has achieved great success. Today, over 75% of all web browsers in the world has WebAssembly execution engines built in. However, just like Java and JavaScript before it, WebAssembly is now finding wide applications beyond the client-side web browser, and it's making its way into the server side as well. Now, with the effort from the open source community and support from enterprise software companies like Oracle, Red Hat, Parity, and of course, Second State, WebAssembly is becoming the bytecode execution engine for cloud-native applications. Now, compared with Java virtual machine and JavaScript execution engines, WebAssembly supports many more programming languages, including the very popular Rust, Go, Python, and others. WebAssembly is also much closer to the underlying hardware, and hence it's much more performant than Java and JavaScript. This point is especially important in the new world of AI computing. With WebAssembly, it's easy to build new hardware extensions that can easily and safely take advantage of the new AI hardwares, like the AI chips, AI inference chips, which could boost performance for 1,000 times for certain applications. Indeed, providing cloud-based AI hardware services is the focus point of Second State. Compared with low-level virtualization containers like Docker, WebAssembly is lighter, safer, and easier to manage. WebAssembly is supported on virtually all operating systems available today. WebAssembly bytecode applications can run just about anywhere. There's no need to package your entire operating system inside your container like Docker does. Being a bytecode virtual machine, WebAssembly has a well-designed security model for accessing hardware. It is a lot harder to crash or do dangerous things in WebAssembly than, say, in native environments like Docker. And furthermore, because bytecode applications are a lot more standardized than native applications, that allows WebAssembly bytecode applications can be truly metered based on usage, based on the number of instructions that are being run. That allows cloud providers to come up with pay-as-you-go, pay-as-you-use schemes instead of charging people for idle CPU times or unused disk spaces. Now, WebAssembly on the server side is still an emerging idea in enterprise computing, but it's truly hold great promise in the next generation of cloud computing and AI computing environments. And history would suggest its migration from client-side browsers to the server side would be highly impactful. Open source developers like my company, Second State, are working really hard to develop and optimize WebAssembly-based infrastructure for server-side applications. We will have a lot of video tutorials and code examples to show you how to take advantage of WebAssembly in your own applications. Stay tuned. Thank you.